If you find yourself fighting an international ring of terrorists or battling a 15-foot steel robot, chances are you're actually just a fictional character in a movie. Or maybe you should lay off the shrooms. This is Movie Night. Hello and welcome to Movie Night, YouTube's weekly interactive movie review show. I'm your host, Jonathan Paula. Tonight we'll be reviewing two action films from last fall, the first of which is Abduction. Released on September 23rd, this action thriller starring up-and-comer Taylor Lautner begins with an intriguing premise of adoption and secret witness protection families, before quickly dissolving into a brain-dead action flick. While browsing through a missing person's website, Lautner sees his own photo and begins to question everything in his own life. But honestly, he probably would have been better off just ignoring it, as the movie goes downhill from there after a decently solid first act. Alfred Molina, Maria Bello, Sigourney Weaver, and Lily Collins all hang around and attempt to help Lautner with his identity crisis slash problem with terrorists, but quite frankly, none of them bring anything memorable or particularly interesting to the proceedings.
Who are you, really?
I'm one of your keepers, Nathan. I'm put in place to look after you. It's the arrangement I made with your father in case something like this ever happened.
This is crazy! Call the police or something!
I already tried.
She has heard too much already.
What?
Are you serious?
As soon as you can, dump those clothes.
Don't lose that kid!
Now, in less than 20 seconds, we're gonna hit a soft curve before the bridge. I'm gonna slow down just enough for you to jump out.
Jump?
It's 30 feet down to the river.
Wait a minute, this is insane.
15 seconds. And remember, from now on, do not trust anybody.
Take a breath.
Jump!
It's gonna be okay.
Now!
On the most basic levels of guy-friendly cinema, this movie holds your attention, and it's mostly enjoyable, but just barely. The filmmaking itself is sloppy and fast, the dialogue and one-liners are often cringeworthy, and the fights themselves seem uninspired and borrowed from much better action movies. You throw in a hokey teen romance subplot between the two horny leads and a trendy pop soundtrack, and you've got yourself a recipe for a very mediocre but undeniably entertaining film. Make no mistake, Abduction isn't very good. But if you're in the mood for some gunfire, car chases, and Taylor Lautner shouting every fifth line in anger, you've come to the right place. When the plot finally does settle into place, you'd be hard-pressed to find someone who still cares about the outcome. The ending is predictable and stale, but at 106 minutes, at least it gets there without wasting too much of your time. Although this motion picture grossed $82 million on a $35 million budget, it seems evident that Lautner isn't quite ready for prime time. If he was looking for his own movie to help shake the stigma of the Twilight Saga, I'm afraid he'll have to keep looking. Abduction, a watchable, fast-moving, haphazard mess. Well, those are my thoughts on this film. Now let's take a look at what you had to say about it in the YouTube comments. Here's a Rate-O-Matic to rank our scores for Abduction. A 4 and a 3. Your scores were all over the place. Some folks really enjoying the action while others simply hated the acting and dialogue. You thought it was a bad movie. Mostly agreeing with you, I felt this movie actually delivered in the enjoyment department, but ultimately, it wasn't very well made or acted. I thought it was meh. Our second film tonight is Real Steel. Ostensibly nothing more than a modern-day Rocky remake with 12-foot robots, this movie was released on October 7th and grossed almost $300 million. Set in the near future of 2020, Hugh Jackman stars alongside child actor Dakota Goyo as a washed-up old boxer from the heyday of the human version of the sport. With total carnage and destruction the only way to cull the bloodlust of boxing's many spectators, the sport apparently evolved into a robot affair, where the violence is no holds barred. Jackman is just out to make a quick buck, but after losing another $100,000 robot in a foolishly selected bout, he is saddled with the responsibility of caring for his estranged 11-year-old son, who luckily for him, also holds an affinity for the metal-crashing sport.
Relax, kiddies on our side.
Not funny.
Kind of funny.
You know he has voice recognition, right?
No, he doesn't.
No, he didn't in the lead.
But when Noisy fought in Brazil, I must have put it in. Right, left, uppercut!
Doesn't work.
Right, left, uppercut!
I knew that price was too good to be true.
Give me
we
a
got
second,
screwed.
Let me see if
no.
I can fix it.
Look at God, look how good he looks,
in
too.
Two seconds,
damn.
Let me look at something.
Why didn't you ask the guy to
Relax.
Have a look at us?
Migi, he died.
Oh, what was that? Was that Japanese?
Apokato Nikai.
Let me see if I can reset him to English.
How the hell do you know Japanese?
Video games.
It's a classic Disney-style plot of a family coming together over an underdog project despite initial reservations they had for one another. Careful not to break any new ground, this slightly futuristic retelling of the classic boxing story is skillfully presented, with slick editing, great cinematography, and some terrific acting from our protagonists, especially from the young Dakota, who carries many of the scenes by himself. Inherently, though, it's up to their robotic counterparts to carry many of the film's key fight sequences, a feat which is accomplished with believable and stellar Academy-nominated special effects. Luckily, though, this movie is much more than a shallow live-action rock'em sock'em robot sports film. There's real heart and passion behind the characters that will undeniably have you rooting for them every step of the way. The conclusion is a foregone one, but it doesn't make it any less enjoyable when it finally arrives. Interesting custody battle and romance subplots are introduced early in this movie, giving it some nice depth. But they're sadly abandoned in the final act with no real conclusion provided to either. It's a sore spot for this otherwise solid boxing movie. Real Steel, an entertaining and inspirational underdog adventure. Well, that's what I thought about it. Now let's read some of your reviews from the YouTube comments. Here's a Rate-O-Matic to showcase our ratings for Real Steel. An 8 and a 9. The vast majority of you overwhelmingly loved this movie, everyone praising the special effects to the touching storyline. You thought it was an awesome film. Perhaps owning to its familiarity, I wasn't as impressed with the story. But the effects were incredible, the acting was top-notch, and it was done so in a very well-made, if heavy-handed, package. I thought it was great. That's going to do it for tonight's films, though, so now let's see what you thought of some movies currently playing in theaters, with some tweet critiques. Remember, if you're going to the movies this weekend, make sure to submit your Twitter review using the JPMN hashtag to have it featured on an upcoming episode. Next week, we'll be taking a look at two more new films, the first of which was released nationwide today, The Gray, a survival thriller starring Liam Neeson, and Drive, the critically acclaimed drama starring Ryan Gosling, which is new on DVD next Tuesday. As always, I encourage you to buy, rent, or download these films, and let me know what you think about them by voting in the polls below or by leaving me a comment review. Once again, my name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching Movie Night. I hope to see you right back here next Friday.